to How to Fix Your Life, the series that Gabriel from Gabriel Inspires and I, hello, we wanted to collaborate to bring this to you guys. Since both of our channels, a lot of you, we get the question a lot, how do I fix my life? How do I get past toxic relationships? Or how do I get past not like living life to the fullest? Why can't I not just live a fulfilled and happy life? So this is the question we ask ourselves all the time. And so we got together to talk to you guys about it. And in this section today, for this video, we're really going to talk about focusing, how to focus in, how to target, how to identify those areas of our life that need clearing. I want to allow Gabriel to talk a little bit about himself. And Gabriel, would you mind introducing yourself to everyone and give us a little background?
Absolutely, absolutely. And thank you, Lisa, for having me on your channel. Honestly, it is a true pleasure and a privilege. So thank you so much. I help people get very clear on their life purpose. And I do that my way through my tarot readings, through my daily videos, my messages on living a life purpose. So that's pretty much where I come from. And I'm here today to really just show up with the intention of helping you get very clear on whatever emotional traumas you may have had in the past, because I can tell you from my own experiences, like I've had my own emotional baggages and like issues, and I've noticed that that's kept me back for a larger part of my life until I got so sick of it where I was just like, you know what, I really honestly have to make a change. And I'm just grateful that you came out to me. You said, hey, let's make a video on this, because I've had so much experience with that.
Yeah.
That to you guys, you know?
Yes, definitely. Definitely as have I. And I truly appreciate you joining us on this collaboration. So listen, everybody, if you haven't already, I'm going to need you to grab a pen, some paper, a crayon. I don't care what it is, but you're going to need to grab something to write with, guys, because there's a little work involved here today, and we want to be sure that we capture all of our emotions and thoughts as they come up. So the first thing, so pause it if you need to, and then come right back. But the first thing I want us to think about is, why did you click on this video in the first place? Why are you here? Now, when you come up with, why am I here? That could be, I'm not happy, I'm depressed, I can't seem to keep a good, solid relationship, my family relationships are nuts, or my kids, or whatever it is, I want you to write it down now. Why are you here? And if there's more than one reason, feel free to write more than one reason down. So, Gabriel, why are we asking people to write down why they're here?
Yeah, I've noticed that whenever you put idea into physical form by writing it down, just like we have here when we wrote down our notes, I found that it now presents itself in a tangible way. So something that you can actually see. And when you actually see it in front of you, you can then say, okay, well, where did this actually come from? Like for me, just being very real, very honest, I grew up with just me and my mother, and then there was a time where she couldn't afford to pay bills or pay for the rent for the apartment, so we were homeless. And then that was around the time that 9/11 happened, and I started to get this emotional heaviness, anxiety around, you know, what if I'm homeless again? What if I don't have enough money to take care of myself? What if I, and it all just kind of triggered and manifested from there. It's kind of snowballed, basically. It became like this really overwhelming thing.
Right.
And I found that on my journey, while I was trying to figure out like, okay, where does all this stuff come from? I would just write it down. And I would just bring awareness to whatever the category or the label was, like, I don't have big enough muscles. I don't have enough money in my bank account. I don't look good enough. I don't have the right whatever, so on and so on and so forth. And when I wrote it down, I looked at it and I was just like, okay, well, this is how this makes me feel. This is how not having enough money makes me feel. This is how having a shitty job that I hate makes me feel. This is how so on and so forth. And then when I actually started to feel into that, I would notice the thought. Does that make sense? So like,
yeah,
I became very aware of how I felt, and then I became aware of the thoughts. So like your mind can be one of your greatest allies, or it can be one of your biggest enemies. This is what I found, at least from my experience. Mm-hmm. And I found that when you overthink things and you're putting a lot of energy into a particular trauma or a particular issue, mm-hmm. it just snowballs and it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Does that kind of make sense?
It makes total sense. So that kind of sets the stage. This is what we're doing today, folks, right? So we're going to write this down, and hopefully by now you've had the opportunity to write it down. And the reason why we're writing it down, rather than if you were in front of me or in front of Gabriel, you know, in some sort of coaching or working session together, we would ask you, why are you here? And we would ask you to speak these out. Because there's a saying that that I watch a lot of Ayanna Van Zandt, and she says something, what cannot be spoken cannot be healed. Wow. So we, at our way of healing it, because I can't talk to you, he can't talk to you, write it down. Because that's actually speaking it. It's getting it out. So we're getting out, and now we're becoming aware of, okay, these are the things that you've written down. So now we want you to look that over. Look over those things that you've written down, and let's find some themes in it. So for instance, if you know, you've got romantic relationships have not been successful, they've been toxic. Family relationships, you're always being pulled on or in all different directions. Everyone just expects you to give, give, give. It feels like you're not appreciated at work. That's a theme right there. That's a theme that we're feeling. Why now identify, let's look at that theme, right? And identify what is that. If it's something like that, then, well, you're not really valuing yourself, are you, right? You don't really feel valuable. You don't feel like maybe you deserve to be loved. So we want you to look at that now and determine, how does that make me feel? So Gabriel, that how does it make me feel? How can we drill down into that and really begin to become very aware of how these situations make us feel?
Absolutely. So along my journey from just like helping people and observing myself, usually our pain points come in one of four different categories. Maybe all four, I don't know, it depends on the person, but it's usually health, wealth, love, or happiness, okay? So it usually has something to do with any four of those categories. My health is not good because, you know, when I was a kid, I saw my mother having health issues. And because of that, I manifested that somehow, some way through my own point of attraction. I saw my family struggling with money, so therefore I felt like I needed to struggle with money, right? So it comes down to one of those four things. I would say that when it comes to actually saying, all right, this is where I'm at right now, and this is where I want to be, right? It's real simple. How do we get from point A to point B? It's knowing what our current hell is or where the pain is, and knowing where we want to be and how we want to feel, right? So I know at this stage of my life, I know that feeling confident is a pain for me, right? And I want to make sure that I can take that pain of confidence and feel better about that. In the simplest way, if there's something that hasn't been making me feel good, like a past situation or whatever, I want to make sure that I'm aware of how I felt about that and how I can now move into something that feels lighter.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, a big thing that I've noticed through my YouTube channel is people having issues around money, right? The money is not the issue, because the money is just a symbol for what it represents. But it's the pain that someone feels from either having a certain amount of money or not having a certain amount of money. And what they're trying to do is they're trying to feel better about that particular subject, right? Whether it be, again, the money, the health, the relationships.
Right. So we should take what we're at right now, and you don't have to feel like you have to fix everything today. We should have probably said that at the top of this, right? We're not here to fix every area of your life today. Rome wasn't built in a day. This life was not built in a day. It's going to take time to fix. So let's concentrate on the top one or two areas and let's focus in on that. So take the top two, and maybe you just have one major one right now, and that's great, perfectly fine. But let's put it in one of those four areas of pain, because in a later video in this series, we're going to talk about how we're going to address those four areas specifically. So take some time. Again, if you need to pause this video to kind of contemplate it, pause it for a moment. Take some time. Does it fit into health, wealth, love, or happiness? So put that in there. We're going to give you a minute to do that, and then we'll be right back. Thank you for joining us for episode one of How to Fix Your Life, the series. Down below in the description box, you will find the link to Gabriel Inspire's YouTube channel, where he discusses everything life purpose, how to discover, live, and manifest your life purpose. Or please consider continuing on Heart of Inspiration's channel, where you'll find awakening, ascension, and spiritual guidance assistance. Until next time, peace, love, blessings, and joy be unto you today and for all eternity. Namaste.